Okay, good morning everyone. How are you today?
Yeah, fine.
It's very windy today.
Yes.
Keep everyone feeling of staying at home. But why not? You are being brave to come. Okay, very nice. So let's start our last lecture of our measurement course. Previous week, I give you different type of bridge. For example, this deflection type, null type, we saw many examples about also the temperature sensor. And last example was about this one. Deflection type, but if the avometer resistance is not neglected. If we want to count it inside here, we have some other way of calculation. So as you remember, VBD here, it will be equal to VM, which is this I mean value, but it will be IM multiply RM. So how we can reach to this? We need Stefani rule. So Stefani rule, you should make all the voltage line shortcut, all the current sources, it will be open. So voltage source line, current source open. Why? In order to calculate the R Stefani, which is R equivalent. As you remember, the last R Stefani was R Stefani equal to, according to this, it will be, let me check it. It will be two parallel. So I can do that directly. RU and R3, so RU, R3 over RU plus R3. Serial means RV, R1. R1, R2 over R1 plus R2. This is R Stefani. But what is V Stefani of the bridge? What is the V Stefani? In this case, we remove this, we calculate the voltage across this VBD. What is this VBD? Again, we go back to our normals, that one. We can use this equation in order to calculate V Stefani. So as I told you, this is equation. If we want to calculate, this is VBD, okay, this VBD. If VDB, it will be opposite, this minus this. I told you we have four types, this minus this, or this minus this, or not R2 over, it will be R1 over R1 plus R2, minus RU over RU minus R3. So we have actually four possible equations. For our cases, let me choose, according to the example, I will choose this one, V Stefani. It will be VI multiply R2 over R2 plus R1 minus R3 over R3 plus R1. This is only for reminder. If we have R Stefani and V Stefani, so this is V Stefani, this is R Stefani, and here we can put our RM, which is this one. This is RM. Then we can calculate here the VM. This is here. We can calculate VM using this equation. So IM, I can get it here, IM, I can get it from this one, so it will be IM equal to V Stefani over R Stefani plus RM, isn't it? So if I calculate this one, then I can calculate VM. Okay? So let's solve one example. Let's solve one example for this. So we have deflection type bridge is used to measure the value of unknown RU, which is here, unknown RU, okay? So here one type of sensor. I put it in deflection type bridge, this one, R1 500 ohm, R2 500 ohm, R3 500 ohm, and the RU nominal value is 500 ohm. What do I mean by nominal value? When there is no effect on the sensor, okay, zero effect. In this case, 500, 500, 500, 500, it means balanced. Then, So if it's balanced, what is VDB
equal to
zero? Zero. This is balanced. Okay. So now what is the question here? Calculate the sensitivity volt over ohm of the change of RM. But what for two cases? If resistance RM is neglected, it means this ammeter resistance is zero. In this case, we can go for normal equations. The next one, which is the resistor ARM, is 10 kilo. So we put it in account. So let's start with this one. How we can calculate sensitivity? S. Did you remember what is the equation? I give you 3-4 weeks ago, if you remember, sensitivity. Is something over something.
Değişim bölü değişim miktarı.
Neydi? Ne değişim?
Dirençteki değişim bölü ölçümdeki değişim.
No, it's change of output over change of input. Okay. What is my output? Not direnç. Output is this
voltaj.
VDB.
Voltaj.
So this is, I mean, change of voltage over change of what?
RM.
RM. Okay. So so it will be change of V over change of VDB over change of RU. Okay. Now to calculate the sensitivity is volt per ohm. It means only one ohm is enough for me. So what is the best value I can start with this one? It's 500 nominal. Why? Because when RU equal to 500 ohm, what is VDB or VO?
Zero.
Zero. So here we are relaxed from calculation. We don't calculate anything. But for calculating sensitivity, is RU equal to what?
500.
Either 499 is okay or 501. 499 ya da 501. İkisi olur. Okay? Hatta sınavlardaki istersen bu 500'den başlama. İstersen başka bir diğerden başlayabilirsin. Tamam? Sadece tek bir değişme için. So 501 ohm, then what is VDB or VDR? This is what R2 over R1. So it's VBD, I'm sorry. VBD. VBD and VBD. Okay, it will be VI. Can you tell me the equation? The equation, tell me, just R what? The equation there.
R2 over
R2 over
R1.
R1 plus R2 minus?
R3 over R3 plus RU.
RU, okay. So what is VI? VR, 10 volt. 10 volt. R2, 500 over 1000. So half minus R3, 500 over 500 plus what?
501.
This. Okay? So what is the answer? It will be 5 millivolt. 5 millivolt. Okay. Now let's apply here. Let's apply here. Okay? So S, it will be equal to
VBD.
Okay, V, but change. So first one is zero. So it, and this one, second one. So it's 5 millivolt minus zero over what? 501 minus 500. So it will be 5 millivolt per ohm. O zaman her bir ohm için çıkış 5 milivolt değişir. Tabii ki bu linear ise. Bazen linear olmuyor. Ama normalde biz linear olarak hesaplama yapıyoruz. Okay, so this is finished. Let's go for number B. Or not number actually, but number B. Okay. Let me just change the pen. Here, look. Resistance RM is 10 kilo, so I will not neglect the ammeter resistance. In this case, again, If RU is 500, okay? RU equal to 500 ohm. What is VO?
Zero.
Zero, it will not change because the 500, it will not change because it's balanced. So this is 0 volt. But now for RU equal to 501 ohm, what is VO? What is VO? VO actually is VM now in this case. This is now VM. Okay? And what is VM equal to IM RM? RM here, 10 kilo ohm. What is IM? I already showed you. So IM equal to V Epiphany over R Epiphany plus R M, right?
Yes.
R M. Okay. And also V Epiphany I don't know and R Epiphany I don't know. Let's calculate. What is R Epiphany?
R U plus R 3.
R U R 3 over
R U plus R 3.
Plus R1, R2 over?
R1, R2.
Okay, you can put here what? All of them 500 except this one what? 501. So only this one, only this is equal to 501. So the answer, I will directly write the answer. It will be 500.251. Okay. And what is V Epiphany? It's V I
multiply
that one.
R two.
R two over R one plus R two minus R V
R three.
Three. R three plus R U, right? So only this R U here. I can add it.
501.
It's 501. Be careful, folks. The answer will be Stephanie, it will be 0.005 volt. So 5 millivolt. So what? This is same of what?
This.
And I told you that one. It will be same. Then now I have V Stephanie, R Stephanie, and I have all of them. Then what is I am? I am, you can apply all of them here.
5 millivolt.
So it will be I
five,
am
5 milli.
5 over.
5 0 0 point. Or let me calculate directly VM, it's better. So VM equal to I am, so V is Epiphany over. What is VM?
IM
multiply RM. IM is V Epiphany, it will be 0.005 over R Epiphany. 500.25 plus 10 kilo ohm, it means 10 multiply 10 over 3 plus what? Plus what?
Multiply,
I already made it.
This
is IM. And RM. This is IM multiply with RM. Multiply with 10 multiply 10 over 3. The answer will be 4.76. Hold. Now look, VM here 4.76 and here what? Is 5 millivolt, okay?
4.7, sorry, not millivolt.
So look, there is a big difference. This is less, why? Because we include the resistance. For sure, if we have resistance here, the volt will be less. For sure.
Yes.
But calculation in this way. Did finish? No, not finish. We should calculate the sensitivity. What is S here now? S is change of voltage over. So the voltage here is 0 is 4.76 millivolt minus 0 over 501 minus 500, so it will be 4.76 millivolt per ohm. Tabii ki bu neden kolay? Çünkü bu voltajın diğer burası 0. Tamam. Soru var mı bu için? One of my exam, I bring one question about this sensitivity. So try to learn it. It's not so much difficult. Some students they could solve. It's not difficult. Only you should take the difference of VO over RU. And as I told you, it's up to you. You can choose whatever you want. If you want 500, you can choose, for example, 400 and 401. 35, 36 is okay. But this is the easiest. Why? Because it's balanced. The output will be zero. This is the most easy one. Okay. Let's go forward here now. Okay. Any question for this one? No. Okay, let's go for last time in DC bridge today. And I will start with the last lecture of the AC. Apex balance. Apex balance is type of, what can I say, maybe deflection type, you can say. We substitute this R and RV with totally equal resistance. It's both of them equal. What will change here? Here I have potentiometer. I can adjust this potentiometer in order to have what? Balance. How we can? Why? Because look, this is sensor. Nominal voltage, this and this equal. Nominal haridaki normalde ikisi eşittir. Ama tabii ki bir mesela basınç, şeyler, sıcaklık bir şey varsa bu değişir. Değiştiği zaman da nasıl denge kadar gelebilir? Tekrar bu potentiometre. So for this R5, how we can have the balance? This is the equation. V equals, if the R3 plus R6 equal to R2 plus R7. So it means this plus this equal to this plus this. Okay? So this is the apex example. Let me show you just one easy example about this, and then potentiometer R5 here is put into an apex bridge, okay, to balance the circuit. Where look, RU RV 500, look, RU RV 500 equal, and R2 515 R3 480 and R5 100. Calculate R6 and R7 in order to have balance. Okay, what is balance case? Balance case. What is balance case? If R3 equal to R7 plus
R2.
Okay. What we know now? What we know? We know R2 is 515. Do you know R7? No, we don't know. What is R3? 480. And what is R6?
We
don't know. Now we have only one equation, two variable. Bir denklem, iki değişken. Çözebilir? Yok. İkinci denklem gerekiyor. İkinci denklem neydi? Hangisi?
R6 plus R7, 7.
R6 plus?
R7.
Okay, look. What is? R6 plus R7 eşittir kaç?
R5.
R5 güzel. Eşittir?
100.
400. 100. 100. because this is potentiometer and we have R6, R7. So toplam bu eşitiyor, tamam? So you can choose whatever you want. For example, R6 equal to 100 minus R7. We can put this here. So it will be 100 minus R7 plus 480 equal to R7 plus 550. Okay? Calculate. This is there, so it will be 2R7 equal to
5 then what is R7 equal to 27.5 on don't forget then what is R6 R6 equal to what 125 minus 20 7.5 75.5 72.5 72.5 okay so this is R6 R7.
So this is end of my previous lecture and let's start now with the new lecture, which is lecture number
10.
63 değil mi hocam?
Evet.
Abi defa. Ben senden Koreyan'ı yapıp çözdüm.
63'ten 63.5 gelmiş.
Evet hocam.
Bakmıyorum. Şurası hocam o zaman.
Şurası mı?
Evet.
55 değil 65 hocam.
Hocam 2R7 eşittir 65.
Tamam ben hesaplamadım. Bakacağım.
Altmış beş.
Start with, do you want to write it? So, now we vary our convergent elements number 2. We will start with lecture number 10. It's not so much long. As you remember, previous week and now I solve about what? The DC bridge. When we can say we have DC bridge, if the voltage source is DC, but if the voltage source is AC, in this case it's AC bridge. What is difference? DC bridge usually is responsible to calculate resistance. Look, all the example is only to calculate resistance. But if I have inductance, capacitance, usually we go to AC bridge. Again, for AC bridge, we have different type. But here you should be careful that we don't have clear value for the capacitance and inductance. Because of that, we go to impedances. Impedance, I will go to teach you in next year in mechatronic design more details. But actually, impedances for R is similar. For capacitance, is 1 over J omega C, and for inductance, is J omega L. You should have memorized. And I think you study this in analog circuit, I think.
Circuit.
So this is imaginary part, J. Okay? So when we calculate impedances, we can change all our circuit to impedances. So I don't care if I have resistance, inductance, don't care in this case. So again, we have two type, null type and deflection. Null, it means when there is some change, I should adjust this change using potentiometer. Deflection, no. Deflection, if I have any change, I will have some change in output. But here, always we should have some potentiometer. Yes. Let's go for the first one, null type. Look, we have two resistances here, R1, R2. And we have here unknown impedance. So I don't know what is inside. Maybe inductance, capacitance, or maybe together, I don't know, anything is upside. Maybe it will be this shape, look. This shape and this shape. D This is impedance, it's okay. Or maybe inductance, parallel, capacitance. Anything here. Okay? Here I have impedance, but what I mean changeable impedances. What is this here? This is the cheap method to know the output. What I mean by that? Usually if we have AC source, we need here galvanometer. Galvanometer expensive usually. Instead of galvanometer, you can put here normal headphone. Normal headphone. Because you know headphone it can sense you the vibration. Okay? If I have any change here, what will happen? It will vibrate. So you can hear some voice. If you adjust, you can adjust using this one. Adjust until there is no loop. Maybe it will be this way until it becomes straight. Straight, what does it mean? Balance. So this is the cheap way to use the headphone. Again, for the balance equation, ZU multiply R2, look, ZU multiply R2, equal to R1 multiply ZU. Doesn't matter, DC, AC, same, always this multiply this equal to this multiply this, at any time. Okay? So if I write, for example, ZU over ZV equal to R1 over R2, is it correct?
Yes.
Correct? Yes, because ZV R1, ZU R2. How about this equation? Is it correct?
No.
Why? So this is correct, this is not. Why? Because look, it's R1 multiply R2. R1 multiply R2. This is not for balance. So this is not correct equation. Be careful. Always should be in crossway. Okay? So, this is another type. It's called Maxwell bridge. Look now in Maxwell bridge. We have here inductance, resistance together. But together what does it mean? Impedance, ZU. This is normal potentiometer. This is capacitance with potentiometer. This is resistance. What is balance? Now all of them impedance. I change all of them to impedance. Let me show you how. Just let me write here, I think. Okay, first we should change all of them to impedance. So what is V? We have ZBC, we have ZDC, we have ZAD, and we have ZAD. What is ZBC? ZBC, this one. So this is, it's ZR plus ZAD.
LU.
So Z R U. What is
R U plus?
So R U plus J omega L U. What is V D C?
R3.
R3. No, it will not change. It will be the same.
You write in blue pen.
R3.
What is Z A D?
R1 multiply 1 over.
Look, this is Z1, Z1, Z1, ZC over Z1 plus ZC, isn't it? Because parallel. So what is Z1? It's R1. ZC, 1 over J omega C, yes, over R1 plus 1 over J omega C. And it will be equal, you can remove this to be R1 over 1 plus R1 J omega C. What is ZAD?
R2.
It's only R2. This is our calculation, but usually we deal with impedance. Balance is this multiply this equal to this multiply this. So ZB AD multiply ZBC equal to ZBC multiply ZAB. This. So for what we use Maxwell gauge? We use it to calculate inductances, always. Inductance. I know it give you this, but usually we can calculate this. How we reach to this equation? Tabii ki sınavdaki istersen ezberleyebilirsin. Tabii ki bu hemen. Hemen yani çıkabilirsin. Ya da normalde şöyle ezberlemeyi sevmezsen normalde tabii ki bu çıkar. Çok kolay bir şekilde. Nasıl? Bu denklemden çıkar. Bu denklemden çıkar. So how? Let me show you. In balance case, ZBC, this is ZBC. So it's RU plus J omega L U over what? ZDC. What is it? This one. So it will be R1 over 1 plus J omega.
Hocam ZDC oldu.
ZDC, I'm sorry. Yes. It's R2 equal to ZAB. Yes, R3. Over what? This one. R1 over 1 plus J omega Z. R1. Okay? You can multiply both together. Then you can have RU plus J omega LU equal to R2 R3 plus J omega C R1 over R1. Then, this is equal to R2 R3 over R1 plus J omega C R1 over R1. Right? So I divide this into two. So this, right, for us. J omega C. I should enter this to here. So it will be R2, R3 as well. R2, R3. So I enter this to here, and then I divide it by R1. So, R2, R3 over R1 plus J omega C R2 R3. Then, look. Here and here plus here and this real side, and this is what imaginary side. So this equal to this because I mean same. Because you know, I mean, for the complex equation, usually we have real and complex. So this is real part and this is complex part. So and here also we have real and complex. Because of that, RU it will be equal to this, and LU it will be equal to this, and you can see here the equations. So this is how you can, if you want to memorize all, you can calculate it using the equations. Okay. Any question for this up now? Any question? Let's go for last one here. Last one, I mean actually one last, I mean slides. Here, if I want to calculate capacitance or inductance in deflection type, not null type, deflection type. Deflection, we look, I don't have potentiometer. But look Maxwell, I have here potentiometer, I have here potentiometer, and this one look, I have here changeable impedance. This is all null type, but this is deflection type. Deflection, you can calculate capacitance and inductance using those equations. But how we get this equation? It's very easy. I can show you just one of them. Let me just put it here. Or maybe we can Okay. For this one, how we can get this equation first? We have I1 and I2. So let me draw. What is ZU? And this is R3. And then Z1. And then R2. Then we have here this one. Okay? So, I1 and I2. What is I1? Equal to what? I1. So if this is VS, what is I1? Similar to DC. Parallel, right? Yes. So it will be VS over I1. ZU plus Z1. And what is I2?
VS
over
R3 plus R2.
Can I write Z3, Z2?
Yes.
Yes, I can write same meaning. Okay, so then, what is so this is A, this is B, this is B, and this is C. Okay, what is BAD? What is BAD?
What over G over?
BAD here.
Zero types.
Z what?
U
multiply?
I one.
So it will be, so ZU multiply VS over ZU plus Z1, right?
Yes.
And what is VAD?
R3 times I2.
R3 multiply
I2.
Yes, so R3 multiply VS over R3 plus R2. Okay, I'm going now fast because it's similar to DC. It's not, I mean, exactly similar to DC, but here we have impedance. Then what is output VO? VDB or VBD? It's up to you. Okay. If it's VDD, tabii ki sınavdaki VBD ya da VDB ikisi olur. Ve istersen buradan başlayabilirsin ya da buradan başlayabilirsin. Mesela ben şimdi VAD ve VAB kullandım. Tabii ki sınavda istersen VDC ve VBC kullanabilirsin. Okay, so this is equal to what? VBD. So it will be VAD minus VAB. Okay. This is VBD. So VAD, so it will be this one minus this one. Okay. VDA, I think no, this is should be
VDB.
VDB is one. Okay, what is VAD? So here, so it will be VS. ZU over ZU plus Z1 minus R3 over R3 plus R2. We reach to this equation. Okay, but now look. This part here. L or C. Look here. This is impedance. This part. So if I choose capacitance. Okay, if I choose capacitance. Let me check them in here. If ZU capacitance and Z1 is capacitance, so it means what is this 1 over J omega CU and this is 1 over J omega C1. This is if it's capacitance. You can apply this here, then you can get this equation. Why I put two equation, this or this? Because it's depending on what do you want to choose. V from this side or from this side. For our case, ZU, for our case is this one. What is? Okay, up. Here, how we can get this? If you calculate this VDC minus VBC. Tabii ki sınavda istersen bu ya da bu kullanabilirsin. So if the impedance is Z, I mean inductance, this is, I mean capacitance, and this is inductance. In this case J omega nu, and this is Z1 with J on omega nu1. You can apply here. Which one we will get? If we apply here, it will be this. This one. Why we did get this C1, not Cu? Do you know?
Here.
Just let's see your concentration. Why we get here C1? Also we have here Zu. Why?
Because it's impedance.
I know it's impedance, but here is C1, but here is ZU. Why is not CU, for example, here? Let's see your concentration.
That doesn't matter. It doesn't matter.
No, it's matter.
Aşağıda vereceğim çünkü CU'lusu da var. Yani.
Evet, bu sebebiyle. Because it's 1 over, 1 over. So it means, if we apply this here, look, so it means, just let me apply just only for this. If we apply this here, it will be 1 over J omega Cu over 1 over J omega Cu plus 1 over J omega C1. So this opposite, because of that C1 become up and Cu become down because of that. But for this loop is different, this is same. ZU, LU, same. I think enough for today. Do you want to solve example about this? It's only number example. It's same, you just apply. For example, is if I give you, for example, what is C, what is R, just calculate the output. I mean, I think there is no difficulties for that.
No, it's...
Do you have any question? Okay, thank you for listening. Thank you for attending MAMA 324. And this is end of my semester and end of my course. See you in next semester or next year. Thank you.